Hello everyone, last class we discussed about the coherence, spatial coherence and temporal coherence. Now we will discuss about the fifth topic of second unit of interference, that is Fresnel's biprism. In this topic, we will discuss about the construction of biprism, how the coherent light sources are formed in this, and also we will discuss about the determination of monochromatic wavelength of light, and also we will discuss about the thickness of thin transparent film. Fresnel scientist has discovered this biprism, hence it is called Fresnel's biprism. A biprism is essentially a combination of two acute prisms placed base to base, is as shown in this animation. Hence, in this biprism, ABC, the obtuse angle is 179 degrees. In reality, this biprism is made with glass slab whose side is polished in such a way that Fresnel's biprism has formed. Now, consider biprism. The line which is passing the center of the biprism is called principal axis. The line perpendicular to the principal axis and very far to the biprism is called screen. The screen and principal axis reaches at point O. Now consider a light source S is on the principal axis. As shown in this animation, the light ray coming from S will incident on the biprism at the edge of B. After the incidence, the light ray refracts into biprism and emerges out and falls down the point E on the screen. Similarly, the other light ray coming from S will incident on the biprism edge at C. After the incidence, the light ray refracts into the biprism and emerges out and falls down on the point F on the screen. That means the light rays coming from S will incident in all directions of biprism. Similarly, the another light ray coming from S will directly incidenting on the prism along the principal axis and splits into two rays in the biprism at point A. One light ray travels and incidenting on the screen as AX light ray. Another light ray travels and incidenting on the screen as AY light ray. Now, if we extend the BE light ray and AY light ray to the back, then they are appear like a emerging from virtual source S1. Similarly, if we extend the light ray, AX light ray, and CF light ray to the back, then they are appear like a emerging from virtual source S2. These S1 and S2 virtual sources will be act as coherent sources. These two coherent sources superpose on each other and form interference fringes on the screen in the field of AEOF. This is shown in this animation. Moreover, with the help of microscope, we can calculate fringe width beta. If 2D is the distance between two virtual sources and the distance between the two sources and the screen gives a capital D value, then we can evaluate the wavelength of monochromatic source by using this formula. Lambda is equal to beta into 2D by capital D. Lens displacement method. Here the distance between real sources and the screen, that is capital D, can be evaluated physically. We can measure by using scale, but we cannot measure the distance between the two virtual sources S1 and S2 physically. We cannot measure with any instrument. For in order to measure the distance between the two sources 2D, we will use lens displacement method. From this, we can calculate the wavelength of monochromatic source. Now, consider ABC biprism and also consider S source which is very near to biprism. From biprism and light source S, S1 and S2 virtual light sources are emerged. These all are we knew. Now consider a principal axis which is passing through center of the prism. The line perpendicular to the principal axis and very far from the biprism is called screen. Now assume the microscope at the back side of the screen to measure the fringe width beta. In order to measure the distance between the two virtual sources, 2D, we need to consider a convex lens in between biprism and screen. When the lens which is at L1 position, then the images of virtual sources S1 and S2 are formed at S1 dash and S2 dash respectively on the screen. These virtual image distances can be measured with a microscope by moving up and down. If the distance between these virtual images are 2D1 and the distance between the sources and the lens is U, the distance between the lens and the screen is V, then by using lens displacement method, we can write 2D1 by 2D is equal to V by U. Assume this is first equation. Now, if the lens is displaced to L2 position, then these virtual images S1 dash and S2 dash are come closer together on the screen. These virtual images distances can be measured with the microscope by moving up and down. If the distance between these virtual images are 2D2, then automatically the distance between the lens and the screen becomes U, and the distance between the source and the lens becomes V. So, by using lens displacement method, we can write 2D2 by 2D is equal to U by V. Assume this is second equation. When multiplying 1 and 2, then in the right hand side, V by U and U by V will be cancel each other and it becomes 1. As a result, 2D1 2D2 by 4D square is equal to 1. Hence, we can write 2D is equal to square root of 2D1 into 2D2. This 2D value substitute in wavelength formula, that is lambda is equal to beta into 2D by capital D. Then the formula becomes lambda is equal to beta into square root of 2D1 into 2D2 whole divided by capital D will come. Hence, from the above equation, by using lens displacement method, we can determine the monochromatic wavelength of light source. Now, we will discuss the determination of thin transparent film by using Fresnel's biprism. Now, consider a light source having polychromatic wavelength. Here, polychromatic wavelength means it exhibits all wavelengths. Now in this case I will take white light. Now consider two virtual sources S1 and S2. Hence here S1 and S2 are also white light sources. Now consider a principal axis which is passing through center of the biprism. The line perpendicular to the principal axis and very far to biprism is called screen XY. The screen and the principal axis reaches at point O and the distance between the two virtual sources S1 and S2 are 2D. Also consider the distance between the screen and the source is D. Now consider one situation, that means we will study how the central fringe is formed. When the white light ray coming from S1 will reach the point O on the screen and also the white light ray coming from S2 will also reach the point O on the screen. Here the distance between S1O and S2O are equal. Hence, there is no path difference between them. As a result, At point O, central fringe is formed. This should be white color and the remaining bright fringes are colorful. But we are not considering rest of other fringes. We are mainly focusing on central white fringe at present. This can be viewed with microscope. Now consider T thickness, mu refractive index of thin transparent film which is placed on optical view of S1. Then interference pattern is shifted. As a result, the path difference has came in between S1 and S2 light sources. S1 light ray reaches the point B. Similarly, S2 ray also reaches the point P. As a result, the central fringe shifted to P point. This can be viewed with microscope. Let X be the distance displaced by the central fringe on the screen. This distance can be measured with the help of microscope. But for the central fringe, the path difference between S1P and S2P should be equal. That means the light ray time traveled by S1P distance should be equal to the light ray time traveled by S2P distance. Here, time means distance by velocity. Hence, we can write S2P by C0 is equal to S1P minus T by C0 plus T by C. Assume this is first equation. Here, C0 and C are the velocities of light in air and medium. Here, medium means transparent material medium. Here, in S2P, light ray distance, there is no medium at all. Hence, I have written as S2P by C0 on the left hand side. But in S1P light ray distance, T thickness and refractive index mu medium is present and also air medium is there. Hence the time travelled in air is equal to S1P minus T by C0 and time travelled in medium is T by C. Hence I added two time travelings. Multiply the equation 1 with C0 on both sides. Hence we can write S2P by C0 into C0 is equal to S1P minus T by C0 into C0 plus T by C into C0. Assume this is second equation. Simplify the second equation implies we will get S2P is equal to S1P minus T plus T into C0 by C. Assume this is third equation. Simplify the third equation implies S2P minus S1P is equal to minus T plus T into mu. Assume this is fourth equation. Here refractive index mu can be written as C0 by C. Hence the path difference between two light ray sources is delta is equal to S2P minus S1P. Is equal to mu minus 1 into T. Assume this is fifth equation. Here S2P minus S1P is the path difference between the two light rays and this is the central bright fringe. Hence the condition for bright fringe is delta is equal to n lambda. Assume this is sixth equation. Here lambda is the wavelength from 5 and 6 equation, we can write as mu minus 1 into T is equal to n lambda. Well, according to Young's double slit experiment, the expression for displacement fringes formula is x is equal to n lambda d by 2d. Assume this is 8th equation. N lambda is equal to x into 2d by capital D. Assume this is 9th equation. From 7 and 9 equations we can remove n lambda. Hence we can write mu minus 1 into T is equal to x into 2d by capital D. Assume this is 10th equation. Now the thickness of thin transparent film is, we can write T is equal to x into 2d by capital D into mu minus 1. Assume this is 11th equation. So this is our topic. So please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.